Hello guys, this is Sayyid Mohammed Wakas. I'm back with another video. In this video, I will tell you guys about the stairwell pressurization calculation or stairwell pressurization system design. So there I have prepared an Excel sheet, as you can see over there. So by using this Excel sheet, I will let you know guys how you can design stairwell system. But before start designing, you need to understand what is stairwell pressurization system. So stairwell pressurization system is basically intended to prevent smoke leakage through doors into the stairs by injecting a clean air into the stairwell, and the purpose is to provide the highest pressure in this stairwell area with respect to this adjacent space, so that we can provide a safe escape path to occupants and for firefighters, because in a case of fire, this area will be positively pressurized. There will be air sucked from the fans and it will be thrown into that area, and this area will be positively pressurized with respect to that area. So this area needs to be positively pressurized all the time in case of fire, so that no smoke will enter from these doors into the stairwell. So let's start the designing of the system. So first of all, you need to understand the design limitations. There I have prepared the design limitations that you need to understand. So stairwell pressurization system basically have the following design criteria. Delta P, minimum pressure difference between the staircase and adjacent space. As per NAFPA standard, it is 0.18 inches of water gauge, and the maximum pressure between the stairwell and the adjacent space, it should be 0.37 inches of water gauge. So this is the minimum pressure this pressure difference and the maximum pressure difference with respect to the adjacent space. And the air, this is as per IBC, that is International Building Codes, and NAFPA standard 92A. So, and the airflow velocity should not exceed 200 fpm as per International Building Code. When the doors are open, airflow velocity should not exceed 200 fpm. And the maximum force required to open any door handle shall not exceed 30 lbs or 133 N. So we need to keep these limitations in mind while designing the stairwell pressurization system. So there you can see the tables and formulas over here, which we are gonna use to design the stairwell pressurization system. So let's take an example. So as you can see that this is the stairwell shown in this drawing. So there we have an office stairwell that runs 5 floors. Each floor has height of 17 feet. So total floor we have 5, and each floor has a height of 17 feet and the width is 28 feet and length is 48 feet. So width is 28 feet and length is 48 feet, and we have as you can see there are two single leaf doors, that is A2 and A3, and a one double leaf door, that is 6 feet by 7 feet. This is a double leaf door, and single leaf door are 3 by 7 feet. So assume that the doors are open and maximum differential pressure to maintain between the stairwell and the office is, this is the office space and this is the stairwell. So maximum pressure difference is 0.037, as I already told you over here. As per International Building Code IBC, maximum pressure difference between staircase and office space is 0.37, that is adjacent space is 0.37 inches of water gauge. So this is the formula which we are going to use to calculate the volumetric flow rate, that is Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. So what is Q1, Q2 and Q3? Q1 is 2610 into A into leakage area. A is the basically leakage area of the building construction. It is the leakage area due to the walls and due to the floor. So this is the leakage area of the building construction. And delta P is the pressure difference, which we have to use over here, as we already know that this is 0.037. So we have to use table 4 for the leakage area, and same formula we have over here, but this is due to the door. This is due to the building construction material, and this is due to the doors. When the doors are closed, then we need to calculate the flow rate through this equation, but table will be table 5 we are going to use. So this is table, this value will get by using table 4, and this value will get by using table 5. And Q3 is equal to V into A. This is simple formula. Q is equal to VA, here A is the flow area in square feet, and delta P is the pressure difference in inches of water gauge, and V is the air velocity across open door. So as I already told you about this, velocity shall not exceed 200 fpm as per International Building Code IBC. This is the velocity we are going to use in this Q3. So let's move to our calculation. So first of all, we need to calculate the leakage area due to the building construction, that is due to the wall and due to the floor, that is Q1. And then we have to calculate the leakage area due to the closed doors. When the doors are closed, then we need to calculate the leakage area. So that is Q2, this is Q1, this is Q2, and Q3 we'll calculate later. So first we'll calculate Q1 leakage area. First of all, we know that the height of the floor is, that height of each floor is 17 feet. We have total 5 floors, and length is 48, width is 28. So first we will calculate the area. First we calculate the perimeter over here, perimeter of the walls. As you can see that this side is 48, this is 28, this 48 and this is 28. So perimeter of this stairwell area will be 48 plus 28 plus 48 plus 28. So perimeter of the stairwell walls will be 28 plus 48, 2 times, that is 152 feet. And we know that the height of each floor is 17 feet. So area will be 152 into 17, that is 2584 square feet. But we need to subtract the door area from the wall, because we are going to calculate separately for the doors. So we need to subtract the door area. Door area is 84 square feet. How did we get this 84 square feet? Since we have three doors here, this is a double leaf, this is single leaf, two single leaf, that is 3 by 7, 21 square feet, 21 square feet, and double leaf door is 6 by 7, that is 42 square feet. So 42 plus 42, that is 84. So door area will be 84. So 2584 minus 84, the door area, we will get 2500 square feet wall area. So now we have to get the average leakage ratio, that is AL by A. How we'll get this value? This value we get from the table 4. As you can see that this table is basically from NAFPA 92 2012 book, table 4.6.1. since the construction of our wall or the whole building, it's average construction. You can see that tight construction, we need to use this value. Average is this, loose is this. This is for exterior wall, this is for stairwell walls, this is for elevator shafts, and this is for the floors. So first we are going to calculate for the walls. So stairwell walls, average construction area ratio is 0.11 into 10 to the power minus 3. So same we have used over here, that is average ratio 0.11 into 10 to the power minus 3. So total leakage area will be calculated as, you need to multiply this average leakage ratio with the area of the wall which we calculated over here for the stairwell walls. So 0.11 into 10 to the power minus 3 into 2500 square feet. So total leakage area will be 0.28 square feet of the wall, stairwell walls. Now second, for the floor. Floor area, we know that it's 28 by 48. So floor area is 1344 square feet, and the average leakage ratio for the floor from table 4. So this is for the floors, and we know that this average construction, so 0.52 into 10 to the power minus 4. So 0.52 into 10 to the power minus 4. So you just need to multiply area with this average leakage ratio, you will get the total leakage area due to the floor, that is 0.07 square feet. Now Q1 is done. Now we proceed for Q2, that is leakage, area leakage when the doors are closed, that is Q2. Since we know that height of single double leaf door is 7 and width is 6, and two single leaf doors we have, that is height 7 and width 3. So area calculations, this 33 is the, you can get this from table 5 here. 33 is basically the crack length. So this 33 feet is the crack length for the double leaf door from the table 5. So this is from the ASHRAE handbook. You can find the these values in the ASHRAE handbook. There are a lot of doors are given in there. So according to the door size, you have to get the crack length, and then you have to use it in your calculations. So single leaf door crack length is 20 and the gap is 0.006. For double leaf door size 6x7, crack length is 33 feet and the gap is 0.006. So this is the crack length for double leaf door, 33, and the gap is 0.006. And crack length for single leaf door, that is 20, and the gap is 0.006. We got these values from table 4 over here, table 5 over here. So how to get the leakage area when the doors are closed? We just need to multiply this crack length with the gap. So crack length into gap, you will get for double door, double leaf door, that is 0.20, and then for single leaf door, that is 20, crack length into gap 0.06, that will be 0.12. since we have two doors over here, that is A2 and A3, two single leaf doors, so that's why we multiplied this with 2 to get the total leakage area when the doors are closed. So total leakage area, so what is the total leakage area? It will be the sum of all of these, that is due to the wall, floor, door. It will be 0.78 square feet. So next, we already calculated this value area. So it, as I told you, this is Q1 and this is Q2, and this is the formula which we are going to use for Q1 and Q2. We already calculated, so we are going to sum this up. So we are going to use this same formula, 2610 into A, that is the total leakage area, into delta P power 1/2. So this is the constant value, 2610, and the area we already calculated, 0.78 over here, and delta P is the maximum pressure difference. As per International Building Code IBC, it is given as 0.37. So we are going to use this value. So after using these values, Q is calculated as 1243 CFM. This is for one floor only. So we know that we have five floors in this building. So total volumetric flow rate will be 5 into 1243, that is 6215 CFM. So total volumetric flow rate is 6215. But now we have to calculate Q3 also. Only then we will be able to calculate the total volumetric flow rate. So Q3 is given by area into V max. So A is the area of the door, and the effective open area. So we know that we have three doors. A1 is the double leaf, A2 and A3 are the single leaf doors. So A1 is the double leaf, 7 into 6 feet, that is 42 square feet, and A2 and A3, that is 3x7, that is 21 square feet. So for doors situated in parallel around a pressurized space, the effective leakage area is given by this formula. Basically, we have two formulas. When the doors are situated in parallel, we use this formula. When the doors are situated in series, then we use another formula. So I will show you over here. As you can see over here, we have two scenarios over here. First, leakage path in series, leakage path in parallel. So this is positively pressurized with respect to these adjacent spaces. So if it is positively pressurized, that means the air will flow from high pressure side to the low pressure side. So air will flow from here to here like this. So in order to, so it will not let any smoke to enter into the stairwell area. So this is the path in series. So if you have a situation like this, if your flow is in series, then you have to use this formula. A effective area is equal to 1 by A1 square plus 1 by A2 square plus 1 by A3 square. So it depends on number of doors. According to that, you have to use the formula if you have leakage path in series. So this one, as you can see, that stairwell is positively pressurized. Air will flow from high pressure side to the low pressure sides, that is A2, A3, A4, A3. So it will continuously pressurize this area and it will not let any smoke enter into the that area, lift lobby and stairwell area. So as you can see, that this is the path, leakage path in the parallel, and we have the same situation or same scenario in our case. So we are going to use this this leakage path in parallel. So leakage path in parallel, you have to use this formula, that is effective area is equal to A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4. So since we have this condition, that's leakage path in parallel, so we are going to use this formula, A equal to A1 plus A2 plus A3. So that's why we have used this formula, A equal to A1 plus A2 plus A3. So effective open area across doors is 84 square feet, that is the sum of these three doors area. Now the flow rate is given by Q3 is equal to V max into AE, that is Q is equal to VA formula. It's very simple and basic formula. So as I already explained you this thing in the beginning, that maximum velocity that needs to be considered when the door is open is 200 fpm. It should not exceed more than, it should not exceed 200 fpm as per International Building Code section 909.7.2. So we are going to use Vmax 200. So we know that velocity, we know the area. So Q, flow rate to the open door, is given as Q is equal to V into A. So V, we have air is 200 fpm and the area is 84. So total flow rate to the open doors will be 16,800 CFM. So now we will get the total air for pressurization system, that is leakage through the gaps in the building construction plus leakage around the door gas plus leakage through the open doors, that is Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. So we already calculate Q1 plus Q2, that is 6,215, and Q3 is 16,800. So total flow rate, volumetric flow rate required for stairwell pressurization system is 23,000 CFM. So this is the total flow rate we required for 5 floors. If we want to calculate for each floor how much is required, 23,015 divided by 5 floors, so 4,600 is the flow rate required for each floor. 4,603 CFM is required for each floor. So if you want to calculate the so we know that the volumetric flow rate for each floor is 4,603 CFM. So if you want to calculate the grill size, you can also calculate the grill size, because we need to place the grill on each stairwell area. Each stairwell area we will have a grill over here through which air will be thrown into that stairwell area to keep it positively pressurized. So we will have some grill over here. So fan will be at the top of the roof through which air will be induced or injected into that area with the help of a grill over here. We will have a grill over here like a supply grill. So if you want to do the sizing of this grill also, you can do that too. So velocity, which we normally consider for grill sizing, is 500 to 600 fpm, 500 to 600 fpm. So by using the same formula, Q is equal to VA. If you want to calculate the area, area is equal to Q divided by V. So Q, we already know that for each floor, that is 4603 divided by velocity we are going to consider is 600. So total area is 7.67 square feet. Grill area is 7.67 square feet, will be approximately 8 square feet. So 8 square feet, that means it will be like we can say that 4 feet by 2 feet, or 4 feet means 48 inches by 24 inches. So the grill size which we need to place on each floor will be 48 inches by 24 inches size. So this is how you have to design your stairwell pressurization system. So I hope you guys learn something from this video. For more videos, keep watching my channel and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you, and don't forget to press the bell icon.